The search to find the country's best young voices is back. For the next 3 weeks, 5 junior and 5 senior choirs who've made it through the early rounds compete in 2 semi-finals to decide who gets a shot at the title. This week, the junior choirs take centre stage. The young singers, aged 12 and under, have travelled to the Victoria Hall in Bolton for a chance to win a place in the grand final in 2 weeks' time. Welcome to this first semi-final of the Young Choir of the Year from Victoria Hall in Bolton. Behind me are the super talented young singers who've travelled from far and wide to take part. And they are Bax Choir, Heathmount School from Hartford. Next up, it's Blackheath Preparatory School from London. And from Canterbury, Kent College Choristers. Please show your support for Perfect Pitch from Bakewell. And all the way from Sevenoaks, please welcome Amherst School Choir. And as you may have guessed, our choirs have brought their supporters along with them. Great to see so many of you here. In just a moment, each of our 5 choirs will perform, and then our judges will have the tough job of deciding which 3 choirs go through to the final. Our first judge is local hero and 4-time Classical Brit Award winner, Russell Watson. Joining him is singer and presenter, JB Gill from JLS. And completing this year's lineup is celebrity vocal coach and TV presenter, Cary Grant. Our judges, Russell Watson, Cary Grant and JB Gill, ladies and gentlemen. My fellow presenter, Josie Darby, is waiting backstage to hear directly from the choirs as they come off stage. But first, let's get some advice from our judges. Russ, what are you looking for from our young choirs today?
I'm looking for connection, first and foremost. So I want to see that young, exuberant enthusiasm coming through in the performances.
Cary, a word of advice for them?
Doing a performance takes 3 stages. The first one is just to enjoy the song. The second stage is to really work out the technicality of it. But then you must remember that third stage, which is to go back to remembering how much you enjoyed it when you first sang it.
JB, we must remember that these singers are 12 years and younger. Nerves are going to play a part. They've got to be brave.
You just got to give it 100%. You know, all of the people who they've been working with, all of their teachers and accompanists and so on, have been, I'm sure, drilling them very, very well. So it's time to shine now.
Big thanks to our judges, ladies and gentlemen. First choir to perform is Bax Choir from Heathmount School in Hartford. But before they sing, let's find out more about them.
I find the choir very fun, and it's been a privilege to be in it so far.
Because our choir is ranging from year 5 to year 8, it's also a good way to meet new people and to socialise with them.
Our choir leader, Miss White, is very, very funny, and she loves unicorns.
She sometimes can be a bit strict, but that's only to help the choir and because she knows what we are all capable of.
Put your hands by your sides. Right.
Our first piece is Circles of Motion by Bob Chilcott, and I chose this piece because it's really uplifting and the children seem to connect to it in terms of the music and also the words.
I find Circles of Motion very joyful and happy because it like tells us to pray and that we are the world together.
Some of our choristers were involved in Young Choir of the Year in 2016 and they're absolutely thrilled to be taking part again.
The tips I would give, having been in the finals before, is to not get so nervous because once you're on the stage, you just focus on your choir master.
BAS! BAS Choir!
never easy going first. They did a fine job.
I feel like they've just set the bar so high. I love the way you did not take your eyes off your conductor. You were like a hawk, all of you, just absolutely one voice, beautiful line, lovely held notes. And when you got to that breathe-in section, I felt like, oh, I was just breathing with you. It was lovely, lovely sound.
JB, were you impressed?
Absolutely. Brilliant balance between all of you. You know, you couldn't single out any real mess in there. It was so polished, so well drilled. You know, hats off to yourselves. The only thing that I would say, and it's probably down to the song choice more than anything else, is that I felt I needed a bit more light and shade in the dynamics area of the piece, but I thought you guys did a fantastic job opening up the competition.
And Russell, let's have your thoughts.
I think if that's the benchmark for the rest of the day, it's going to be absolutely brilliant. You all look very, very confident. It didn't appear like you were you nervous? If you were, it didn't...
Of course they weren't nervous.
It didn't appear like they were nervous at all. I thought they were brilliant. I thought your delivery was very, very strong and absolutely wonderful. Well done.
Thank you very much, judges. And a huge round of applause for Bax, Heathmouth School Choir.
So, you were first on. It's a big deal, isn't it, to open a competition like that. And what did you think of some of your comments you had? Russell seems to think you're brilliant.
Yeah, I think I'm really happy with the comments.
Yeah, you should be, I think. How did you feel when you were on stage?
I felt quite proud when we had like finished the song. Mm-hmm. I'm really happy just to be here.
They did a fantastic job, they really did. They really rose to the performance, which was brilliant. Yeah. So I'm really, really pleased. Well done to all of you.
Yeah, well done everybody. And what do you think about Cassie?
Our second semi-finalists are from Blackheath Preparatory School in London, and we've been along to meet them. Chicken, tikka,
mango, chutney and a Coca-Cola. The chamber choir is very special to me because we're able to choose more challenging pieces. I'm really able to work on their technique.
Okay, right, okay. Gospel trains in the distance. One, two, three.
Gospel train, it's saying that we're all equal in God's eyes and we all... have a place on his chain to heaven.
The children really love that song because they can use their singing technique in so many different ways. They love the sound effects.
It's very energetic and uplifting. This is Big Ted. Some of our medals we put on Ted because it represents us and represents like what we've been through and how much we're enjoying the choir.
If we won, I think it would be like one of the best days of my life, because I've never been on a competition, anything like this.